Louis B. Hey loves, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is gonna be all about New Year's Eve and how to slay for the new year. So this video is gonna be all about how I achieved this hair look, as well as where I got this outfit. And yeah, if you wanna see more, please stay tuned.
Bad thing, fine as hell.
Okay, so first and foremost, I love a good bob. Like, I love it. I feel like it is super chic and it's just, you know, timeless. I remember re-falling in love with the bob when Riri did it. So yeah, I was like bob crazy at that time. And just ever so often, every time I do a wig, I always do some type of black, jet black, dark brown wig. So you know I was super excited, you guys, when Wig Encounters reached out to me to review their Indian Remy wig. Their Indian Remy bob wig. Because I already make them like every couple of months. I had one that I wore like in Paris. That girl, I do not know where my wig is. Like, I looked everywhere for that wig, like high and low, and I cannot find the wig. So I'm convinced somebody in Europe has stolen my wig, okay? Because I made that wig pretty good. But needless to say, I did not have a bob wig anymore because it came up missing. So yes, I was really excited to do this review so that I can get my wig back, you know, get my bob wig. I need to have that in the stash, you know, just in case. So a little bit about Wig Encounters. Basically, they are a hair company that sells wigs that are kind of like beginner friendly. So, you know, some people are really intimidated by wigs. They feel like they look bulky or is gonna look super wiggy. So most of their wigs, like from what I've seen on reviews and what I've experienced myself, they are more on the thinner side, which allows them to look a lot more natural, and they are a bit easier to work with. The last wig that I had from them was the really wavy, kind of dark, wavy, curly hair that everybody and their mama would ask me about that wig, and I loved it, girl. I felt like I was chilly in that wig, honey. I'm telling you, it was so, so cute. And because it was like a thinner type of wig, it just looked really natural and really good. Okay, so some specs on this wig. It is a full lace wig and can be parted anywhere and also put into a ponytail. Girl, you're gonna have a little chicken head ponytail, girl, if you put this in a ponytail, but you can do that. It's Indian Remy hair, and I had ordered a jet black, but the jet black was out of stock, so I got this in their natural black. The hair length comes in 12 inches. The hairline density is 130%, and then the density in the back is 150% density. It does come with some baby hair around the perimeter, and it also has a natural pre-plucked hairline. The lace is Swiss lace material, and it says that it has bleach knots around the perimeter, but I really didn't see that. So I'm not sure if it did. I'm into making these wigs as simple as possible. So as far as the hair is absolutely gorgeous. It's super soft and it has a lot of flow to it. And that's what I really like about the hair. Now, it being on the thinner side, that is a plus because it looks a lot more natural. However, with me, my braids, girl, Lord, I need to redo these braids. Let's just put it like that. So I have a lot of new growth and my braids are really big, like underneath this. So I would just recommend, if you're gonna wear this type of wig, you need to make sure your braids are flat, because any little, you know, bump in your beehive or your braids to the back or anything like that, it will show, because this wig is not a bulky wig. It is very natural and it's not a ton of hair. So you need to make sure that your hair is flat underneath this. If you're a person that already has hair all the way down their back and it's really thick or something like that, you might have an issue with your hair showing. My hair is like shoulder length and it is fairly thick. So I think that if I just would have had fresh braids going to the back, it would have been pretty flat and I wouldn't have had any issues. But I can see like a little bit of bump because my braids is just a hot mess up under here, girl. So that's really my own thing. So that's just something to keep in mind. Next, the hair did not come looking like this, honey. I put some work, okay, into this wig. Like when I say I put some work into it, I really did. Like it was bobbish, but number one, the part was on the opposite side and I do not wear my part on this side. I like to have it coming this way. So in order to get the hair on the other side and for it to lay flat, girl, the hair was stubborn, it didn't want to do it. I was wetting it, I was blow drying it, I was flat ironing, I was pressing it. And it still has like a little bit of puff right here, but you know, it's nothing that's too bad. It's kind of more like me being a perfectionist or whatever. So basically, if you keep it in the parting that they give you, then you should be fine. But if you're like me and you want to change the parting and you want to put it down the middle or you want to put it on the other side, you are going to have some work to do in order to get it to lay flat like you want it to. And then I also, because I wanted my part on the other side, it kind of threw off the cut. So then I had to go in and cut it. So to make the process a little bit easier, I seen, I think it was Peak Mill, which is, she's one of my favorites. I love her so much. But anyway, I seen Peak Mill cut with a clipper and I had just got some clippers because I wanted to try to cut my son's hair. Girl, that's a whole nother story. But anyway, I had got some clippers for him and I was like, you know what? I got some clippers in there. Let me try to use the clipper technique. And girl, it was the best thing ever because I get really nervous with trying to cut it with scissors because I'm not really that good at it. And I think that the clippers just made it so much easier. So it gave it a really like blunt type of look without too much work. I think that was the easiest process out of all of this. So I think the hardest thing was just trying to get my parting the way I wanted it and to lay it straight, lay it flat. And then I just put a little bit of concealer in the parting, or actually some powder in the parting, and that was pretty much it. I absolutely love the hair. I love how natural it looks, and I can't wait to see how it'll look once my braids are actually flat. So yes, that is my review of this hair. Wig Encounters is awesome. I definitely can see myself buying from them a lot more in the future, as well as working with them as well. They are a great company and I really truly have no complaints. I mean, they do have some of the most natural looking wigs that I've encountered. So on to the outfit, honey. Yes, I wish I could have got this out to you guys a lot sooner so that you could have purchased this for New Year's Eve or something like that if you wanted to. But I do think that this is just a great event dress in general to wear on your birthday or just somewhere where you want to show up and stunt. So this dress is available on Shop Lace and Leopard. It is a velvet stripe, sequence striped mini dress. And it is so comfortable, so soft. You don't feel no sequence at all. The whole inside of it is lined, so it feels amazing. And it really does a lot for the figure and hides the tummy really well. Beyonce actually wore a dress very similar to this. And I was just like, you know, we gotta get some Beyonce vibes going up in here. So yes, I am totally in love with this dress. I feel like I did a phenomenal job as far as picking this out. I just really love the zipper detailing, just everything about it. I think that this is probably my favorite, absolute favorite pick that I've ever made for my store. You can wear this plain, or it also comes with this belt that laces up in the front, which is super sexy, and it just accentuates the waist just even more. So yes, I thought that that was a great detail, and I just love this dress so much. I think that it'll be great for a birthday dress, New Year's dress, I mean, just any type of event. So let me go ahead and stop talking and get to this dress, honey, so you guys can see the entire look. All right, you guys, let's go ahead and get into this full look. Don't forget to check out Wig Encounters. I will leave all of their information in the description box below, as well as all the deets on this hair. And I will also leave the link to this dress at Shop Lace and Leopard. So until my next video, have a blessed day, have a blessed week, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.